Do you want to know how to blend multiple consistent characters into a single harmonious environment? In today's video, I'm going to reveal my ultimate hacks of achieving character consistency for your storybooks or for your movies. We're going to use the new Character Consistency GPT from the GPT stores, and you'll learn how to unite all the characters you generated there into one cohesive scene. I'll share with you the secret to harmonizing your characters in your settings for the best results. And you won't need advanced graphic design skills or techniques for this. So let's jump right in. To create consistent characters, we're using the Consistent Character GPT from the GPT store. With this GPT, you can get fairly consistent results of your characters because they can use the same scene number to maintain consistency throughout the session. While in a regular GPT, you cannot use the scene number to generate consistent images. For those who don't know, scene number is the number that determines the random element of the image creation process in DALL-E, which helps to create images in a consistent way. First, let's go to ChatGPT, click Explore GPT. Type in Consistent Character GPT in the search bar and you will find the GPT by AI Lemon Academy. Click and start creating character design. Answer the questions about gender, name, and details about your characters. Then it would generate the initial image and ask you to specify variation from the following images. The GPT then would take the prompt of the first image and vary only things like expression, action, or pose of your characters as per your instruction and with the same scene number to maintain consistency. The unfortunate reality is that although such a refined control of input, it still doesn't always give perfect consistent images. But in one of the sessions I tried, I copied the prompt and edited it myself in a Consistent Character GPT and managed to get pretty good consistent characters. I think even with this GPT, sometimes it still takes luck and trials and errors to get consistent results. With the latest update, the GPT can now generate background with the characters, while before it can only generate a plain background. As you can see, these images, the characters with the background images do not look as consistent, although they are created using the same scene number according to the GPT. The variation is because when more details are included in the prompts, they tend to confuse DALL-E during the image creation process. There's a trade-off between details and consistency that's worth considering in your creative process. So in this tutorial, I would use the characters with the plain backgrounds only, as the goal of this video is to achieve the most consistent results. My main character alone seems to be too lonely here, so I created a white cat and a gray rabbit in the same session using the Character Consistency GPT. After you download the images you prefer, we will put these characters within the single environment next. To ensure the highest level of consistency, the best way I find is to take the characters and build the environment around them. I will show you two of my favorite methods of putting them all together. One of the quickest and easiest methods to achieve our goal is by using the AI functions in Canva Plus. Go to Canva and create a design. Choose your preferred frame size. I selected video for this example. Upload your character image. Select an image, then click Edit Photo. Under Magic Studio, use the BG remover to remove unwanted backgrounds. Adjust the image cropping as needed, and use the magic eraser to remove any parts you don't want in the final image. Repeat these steps for each character. Now let's generate the background. Go to Apps, find Magic Media, and under the Text to Image tab, enter your desired background prompt. For example, I simply enter Pixar style Magic Forest. Choose a style if desired, and then scroll down and select the aspect ratio. I selected landscape for this one, and you will get 4 options at a time, regenerate if needed, or select one to add to your canvas. Then we adjust the size, click position, and drag the background layer to the bottom. Reposition your characters and add shadows to create depth. You want to make sure that the light source direction is consistent for all characters. For example, if the main lights come from the upper right, the character should have a brighter side on the upper right side. Shadow should then fall on the opposite side. If you want to edit something on the background, first select the background image, click Edit Photo, and click Magic Edit, and then brush over the area you want to edit. Here, I want to turn this orange butterfly into a blue one, so I brush over this area. and hit continue. Here you will describe what you want to see in this selected area. And here I type make it blue and then click generate. It turns the original butterfly to blue without changing its shape. How cool is that? Click on the generation to preview the result. Once you see what you like, click done. If you want to change the look of the butterfly, simply change the prompt to a blue butterfly. So here we have put all the characters into the same canvas. Do you like what you see? For some of you with eagle eyes, you might still sense that the characters don't quite fit the environment. So for that, I will share with you my secret hack in the next step to help further refine the result. We're going to use this AI tool to relight the environment. All the links mentioned will be in the notes of this video in the description. Upload your image by dragging it in or using the upload option. You can start with the preset lighting options by clicking on these options. Ambient lights provide diffuse lighting across the entire scene. You can customize this by adjusting the light's color using the color picker and modifying the light's power intensity here. You can add additional light sources and reposition them by dragging them around. Each light can be fine-tuned in terms of color, power, distance, and radius. The power controls the intensity of the light, affecting how strongly it affects the scene, and the distance determines how far the light reaches, influencing the spread of illumination. Radius adjusts the size of the light source, which affects the softness and spread of the light. To learn more about the details, you can see the link in my notes. For example, I want a blue light source coming out from this fish-like creature on the tree, so I simply drag one of the light source to the spot. And then you can adjust the light to the desired effect. Play around with it to find the ideal setup for your image. And if you need, you can remove any light source by clicking the delete button. And you can use the preview button to view your image without the light source indicators, both on the entire canvas and on the individual lights. Once you're satisfied with the result, download your final image. And here's the final image. So for some of you super picky people, you may think that this is not good enough. So let's take it to the next level with Photoshop's AI tools. The difference we're doing here is that Photoshop allows us to generate an environment with our characters in mind, making sure that the lighting and shadows harmonize with them for a more integrated look. It's also a powerful tool for refining the finer details of our characters, a task that can be challenging with other tools. And I apologize that this will not be a step-by-step Photoshop tutorial for beginners, but I just want to give you an idea of how to use the AI generative tool for character consistency. First, let's give the character a haircut in Photoshop. Open Photoshop, know that you will need the 2024 version of Photoshop to use the AI generative tools. Load the image and zoom in for a better view of the area you want to edit. First, I want to edit the weird blue reflection on her face. Select the lasso tool from the toolbar and circle the parts you want to edit. With the area selected, click Generative Fill. This option appears below when a selection is active. Here, I just want to see more balanced colors, so I will leave the prompt area empty for the AI to reimagine how those areas should look like. Click Generate. The Generative Fill tool creates a new layer over your original image, offering three variations to choose from. Click the arrow on the Generated toolbar to see different options, or you can also select from the property panel of the generative layer. Then using the same method, we can adjust the hair length by selecting the hair area we want to remove. Here I type in blue background as the prompt because I want to replace the current hair area with just the blue background, so the hair becomes shorter. It may take a few tries, and once you get a closer result of what you are looking for, you may want to create another generative layer on top of the previous layers simply by selecting the area you want to remove again by looking at the visible results on your screen. Bit by bit, you can get the desired hairstyle. Next, let's put the characters together on the same canvas. Open the right canvas size of your choice. Put in the characters and remove their backgrounds. For a character sheet with multiple objects like this, you can use Object Selection tool to select the one that you want. Ctrl-C to copy that selection, and Ctrl-J to create another layer with just that selection. Then you can hide or delete the original layer below. Adjust the size and position of each character, keeping light directions in mind. Right-click on any of the layer in the layer panel, and then select Flatten Image. Change the background layer to a normal layer by clicking on it. Now we want to select the characters. Click on the Object Selection tool and make sure you're set to Add to Selection. Now click on each character or roughly select the character. The AI will smartly fine-tune your selection, capturing the precise areas as needed. Once all characters are selected, head over to Select, Modify, Contract. Adjust the contract setting by about 3 to 5 pixels. This step is crucial as it helps eliminate any residual background elements that might peek through finer details like hair or fur. By contracting the selection slightly, we ensure that only the solid areas of the characters are included, preventing any stray background colors from affecting the result of the generation. Zoom in to make sure you are selecting the area you want and add or subtract unwanted areas. And then we want to reverse the selection to select the background only. Right-click anywhere and click Select Inverse. Now we have the proper background selected, we can use the generative tool to generate the background. Here I type in Magical Forest with Butterflies Pixar Style and click Generate. I actually don't know if the Photoshop generative tool would recognize Pixar style, but anyways, you can see that the backgrounds better complement our characters and also incorporate appropriate shadows and lighting on the finer details. And you get to achieve a more harmonized result with Photoshop because the background is generated with your characters in mind. If you don't like your first attempt, just generate again to find the one you like. For the finishing touches, zoom in and meticulously refine the details using generation tools. This helps to ensure that the characters and background meld together more seamlessly. And done. So what do you think of these results? Is this process faster or slower than the traditional way of doing the same thing? I'm curious, especially if you're an illustrator or animator. Let me know your thoughts. If you're interested about how to create your own custom GPT for your multiple consistent characters, watch this video, and I will see you there.